بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our case today very interesting. 1-month-old girl brought by her mother to the clinic for general follow-up during physical examination found to have blue eyes, cloudy cornea, more in the right side. So after full evaluation examination, the patient referred to ophthalmologist to rule out primary congenital glaucoma, most probably retinoblastoma, especially if there is index case in the family. So what is primary congenital glaucoma? What is the clinical triad of the glaucoma? There is epiphora, blepharospasm, and photosensitivity. So epiphora, this means excessive lacrimation of the eyes, watery eyes. So it misdiagnosed as nasolacrimal duct obstruction, and also blepharospasm, this means firmly squeezing of the eyelid or contraction of the eyelid, and also photophobia, this means there is sensitivity to the light, So this is clinical triad. It will be epiphora, blepharospasm, and photosensitivity. What is the causes of the congenital glaucoma or glaucoma? There is inheritance, metabolic, traumatic, genetics, can be congenital, can be infantile, can be juvenile, and the tumor also. You have to rule out retinoblastoma, and iridocorneal dysgenesis. What syndromes associated with glaucoma? There is phocomatosis or Strige-Weber syndrome, and also Lou syndrome, it's called oculocerebrorenal syndrome, and also the treatment of such cases, the aim to decrease the intraocular pressure. But put in your mind, no rule for medical treatment. The only definitive treatment, surgical treatment. If you are going to give medical treatment, it will be beta blocker to decrease the intraocular pressure. But the definitive treatment, surgical treatment, geniotomy or trabeculotomy. And also follow up, it's very important. You have to follow by ophthalmologist looking for intraocular pressure, normal intraocular pressure 10 to 21 millimeter mercury, and looking for corneal diameter. If more than 12 millimeter, this means megalocornea. But megalocornea, you to mention megalocornea should be normal intraocular pressure with large cornea, But if there is large cornea with increased intraocular pressure, it is called glaucoma. And also you have to follow the fundus and optic disc if there is cupping. So the message from this case, there is 5 B's. Glaucoma, common in boys, bilateral, 2/3 of the cases. Blepharospasm, this is mean firmly contraction or squeezing of the eyelids. And blue eyes or ox eyes, ionothaur, bull's eyes, and also triad of the glaucoma, epiphora, blepharospasm, and photosensitivity. And you have to follow this patient for intraocular pressure and corneal diameter. So put in your mind, glaucoma, there is 5B, boys, bilateral, blepharospasm, and blue eyes, pulls big eyes or ox eyes. And once the patient having lacrimations or epiphora, don't misdiagnose this one as nasolacrimal duct obstruction. You have to do full examination of the eye to rule out primary congenital glaucoma. And put in your mind, there is family incidence for retinoblastoma, to rule out retinoblastoma. ومن أحيا فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا, سلام عليكم.